get situated up here, I just want to follow up on that that chamber performance. I wanted to play with them, and the great thing about that kind of setting, what you would call a chamber setting, usually under 12, 10 musicians, is there's no conductor. First of all, students, what do I say? Who keeps the pulse in the band? Everybody. It's not on the conductor, it's not only on the drummer, it's on everyone in the entire ensemble to really groove and vibe with each other, all right? What a chamber group like that is, you're forced to not have a conductor. The students are really listening keenly to what everyone else is doing, and it's a great musical exercise for all students to do. And now we have up here the Full Symphonic Band. This band has been a lot of fun to work with. I only get to see this large group every other day. My concert band, my wind ensemble, I essentially see them every day as a full group. I see these guys every other day. I really look forward even more, because I only see them every other day, to working with this large group of students. They put out a nice fat sound. And we're going to play a couple of really contrasting pieces, both with three movements. The first one is Three Airs from Gloucester. It's three settings of English folk tunes that go back several centuries. It features the entire ensemble. Hugh Stewart, the composer, really brought out a lot of unique instruments. Like, you hear the French horn a lot, you hear the Barry sax come out. All these different instruments in the ensemble he really features. So it's a great exercise in listening to all the different instruments.
Thank you.
So the next piece we'll be playing, I know a lot of you saw the program, and we're pretty excited to see it in the program. Back in March or April, when I saw the official release date of the new Star Wars film, I knew I had to do something Star Wars at this concert. I know some of these students did something, maybe at Cedarbrook, if you're in ninth grade, you did something, but I promised to one-up that and give them a nice meaty piece. And this Star Wars piece is a really difficult arrangement. I told them at the beginning, this is something that is really going to challenge you and really push them. And what's great about this is it's introducing the students, if they don't already know, to John Williams, who's really not only one of the greatest film composers of all time, but probably one of the greatest composers, period, of the 20th century. He writes all of his scores in an operatic style, meaning he'll take a theme and he'll apply it to a character. He'll take a certain issue, apply it to a certain motif in the film. And it's a very operatic way of writing that Wagner actually did in the 19th century. He's essentially writing an operatic music for a film. And that's what John Williams really mastered. And so we're going to hear a few of those different themes from the original, not the prequels, not this one that just came out, but from the original late 70s, early 80s trilogy. And we're going to hear a few different themes. We're going to start out with Princess Leia's theme, a very elegant theme to represent the princess, obviously. And then we're going to totally shift gears, and you see the Imperial March is on there. So that's a total shift in gears, and you all know that all too well, that infamous theme. And in that same movement, we will go into Episode 6, Return of the Jedi, into, here's some nerd knowledge for you, the forest battle on the moon of... Thank you, Endor. On the forest moon of Endor, there we go. So there'll be like a nice battle, really swift, fast music there. And then we'll round out this multi-movement piece with the main title, really brilliantly done here. So this is the symphonic band, and we can get tuned. We did not tune. But we always have good ears in this ensemble, so they're always listening. So let's tune.
Thank you.